What is the difference to you between a plant that's been engineered using modern methods and one that's been selectively bred? And I love to hear the science version of it, but if you wanted to use an analogy of something else, I'm also open.
Sure. Traditional breeding, that is really relying on the diversity that already exists in the crop. So if you think of something like corn, there is literally thousands and thousands of different varieties of corn. And with breeding, what you do is you will cross between those different varieties, and then you will screen their offspring to find ones that are better, that have traits that are better than either of the parents. And so what you're doing there is you're really just taking, here's all the genetic diversity that exists, and then you're, and here's my analogy, then almost like a deck of cards, you're gonna shuffle it and then randomly start dealing hands to see, okay, is there a hand that's better? Is it, what is the best hand? So it's a random process. It's using a limited set of genetic diversity that already exists, and it requires a lot of numbers. You have to make a lot of progeny and just screen through them. It works, it's extremely successful, but it is, that's the general approach. If you think of some of the modern techniques like GMOs or even gene editing, basically what you're able to do there is you're really able to stack the deck. So rather than randomly shuffling all of your genes and then empirically searching for the best hand, with GMOs or gene editing, you have some knowledge going in and you can start to say things like, well, I want an ace. So let me either go in and find that ace first, or at least let me take a peek in and maybe enrich for the likelihood that I'm going to draw an ace. And so that's one way of thinking about it, is that it's, with these newer techniques, you can be a bit more targeted. It requires a little more knowledge of exactly what you want to get. It requires better understanding, mechanistic understanding of the underlying biology, but then allows you to go in and then really create that trait or that characteristic that you want, like I said, and doing it in a fast way and without having to create all the numbers of varieties that you need to screen through.